Welcome back to NHL Goalie Breakdowns presented by MAP South Goaltending. Thank you for the support, and if you missed any of our previous installments, they are posted on our Instagram account and YouTube channel. This week we will focus on the highly underrated Jacob Markstrom. Markstrom is a tremendous athlete combined with a massive 6'6 frame, which makes him an imposing target for shooters. He's always had tremendous tools. It is why he was a second round pick back in 2008, and I love his story. Despite having a lot of early success at the World Juniors and the AHL levels, he couldn't break into the NHL as a full-time goalie for 6 years after being drafted. He faced adversity and finally jumped the hurdle of being an NHLer, and finally earned a starting job in 2017, 9 years after being drafted. He played relatively well, but had inconsistent results. His challenge was set in place by new goalie coach Ian Clark. Some may know, Clark is credited with the success of Roberto Luongo and Sergei Bobrovsky and helping them become elite goalies. In reading articles and chatting with friend of the program, Ron Mays, the challenge set in place by Clark essentially boiled down to, you better change the way you train and train to be elite, or you can be average somewhere else other than Vancouver. Clearly, Markstrom heeded Clark's advice, as Markstrom was a strong contender for the Vezina up until his injury in February. He had strong traditional and advanced statistics behind a young, up-and-coming Vancouver team. The change wasn't so much a technical alteration, but a commitment to having elite habits on and off the ice. Now let's get into the line rush analysis of Markstrom game, starting with the strengths and weaknesses off the rush. Markstrom's first trait is his athleticism. For a man as big as Markstrom is, he is remarkably agile and athletic. His ability to get to pucks on lateral plays is incredible and will be on full display in multiple man attacks. Markstrom's second trait is his head and eye habits. He does a tremendous job tracking pucks off the stick blade and maintaining visual attachment throughout the save cycle. You will also notice he does an excellent job of leading with his head and eyes on pass plays to get an early read on the play. Markstrom's third positive trait is his depth selection. I want you to pay attention to how Markstrom's depth differs depending on the situation. He will be aggressive to fill up space on one-man attacks and breakaways and sacrifices a good amount of depth when there are passing options. He does a great job of balancing this area, which is a great sign of intelligence. Markstrom's fourth trait is his compete. This trait relates back to our intro and how he has developed an elite mindset. His desire to make saves in any facet necessary is what has him in the discussion as one of the best goalies in the league, and doing it on a nightly basis. It is much easier said than done, and Markstrom has that stop the puck at all costs mentality. Our first line rush clip is an outside shot on a one-man attack by Patrick Kane. Vancouver does a good job eliminating the pass option, forcing Kane into a shot from the top of the circles. Notice Markstrom's effective depth selection. He knows he is still an imposing target with his toes at the top of the crease, and this also gives him the ability to react by buying himself a bit of time. The shot is taken high blocker, and Markstrom throws up his shoulder to put the puck into the corner. As you can watch, he maintains visual attachment and recovers to his post. Good, simple habits. On this one-man attack, Thomas Hertl gets a step on the Vancouver D. Markstrom recognizes that the weak side D is coming across, negating the backdoor threat. Markstrom maintains his depth, is centered and squares as the backhand is taken. Markstrom makes the save and, because of his visual attachment skills, is able to reel in the puck, preventing the Sharks attacker from scooping up a rebound. Now we're going to move into some breakaway clips, the first one with Julian Gauthier of the Hurricanes getting a step on Tyler Myers. Note that Markstrom is more aggressive on this partial breakaway attempt, with depth about a foot outside the top of his crease before beginning his retreat. Gauthier gets the puck in a shooting position, and Markstrom has his nose down on top of the puck, ready to react. The shot is taken glove side, and Markstrom makes an outstanding save, and look at his head and eyes falling all the way into his glove. Great save, just one thing to be careful of is falling on her butt. If he doesn't catch this cleanly, it could cause issues on a potential rebound situation. All in all, great sequence. Here's another breakaway clip with Toffoli of the Kings earning the breakaway after a blocked shot. Again, Markstrom habits remain the same, with excellent depth, and he's ready in a ready position when Toffoli gets ready to shoot. The shot is taken high glove, and again, Markstrom's excellent head and eye habits are on display. He makes a great save and tracks it all the way into his glove as he pops back up to his feet. This clip really highlights Markstrom's elite tracking skills, as this is a very difficult task due to the proximity of the net from where the shot is taken. Here's our last breakaway clip, and it is an excellent save on a deke. Sebastian Aho makes a great pass to Brett Pesce on a breakaway. Again, Markstrom establishes depth consistent with the other clips before beginning his retreat. Pesce has the puck in front of his body. This indicates to Markstrom that he can still pull it to either side. As you'll notice, Markstrom is remarkably balanced, understanding this puck position. Pesce tries to get him to bite with a quick fake, but Markstrom holds his ground. The puck is pulled to the backhand, and Markstrom gathers himself and makes an excellent extension to his blocker side to make the save. Really fun sequence there. I love the consistency in his habits on breakaway situations. Here's a two-on-one after a turnover. Stefan Nason is the puck carrier, and what makes this play particularly difficult is both players are on their off wings. So Kane is a strong 1T option, and Nason has the puck towards the center of the ice. Nason gets himself into a shooting position, and Markstrom is in a great spot. Toes are located top of the crease, and his backward momentum is halted. The shot is taken to his body, and Markstrom does a great job containing the shot. Good job making this sequence look really easy in what could have been a very difficult situation. Here's a Kings 2-on-1 clip, and the puck carrier makes a great saucer pass over the defender. As the pass is made, look at Markstrom leading with his head and eyes. He beats the pass on his feet and delays his butterfly as Kempe tries to slip it back against the grain. As the puck hits his pad, Markstrom is maintaining excellent visual attachment before gathering himself and following it to the corner. Great display of patience and head and eye habits on this 2-on-1 situation. This two-man attack really highlights Markstrom's elite level of compete. The Calgary puck carrier likes to shoot off the rush, and it is blocked, and the play breaks down as the puck goes back to Calgary. Markstrom quickly finds the puck and recovers to the post as the Flame player attacks unimpeded to the middle of the ice. He takes a quick shot low blocker, which Markstrom steers. Calgary again gets to the puck, and a pass is made to the second wave attacker. Despite heavy traffic, Markstrom tracks the pass and slides in anticipation of a one-time shot. Kachuk then holds, making this an even more difficult situation, and Markstrom gets to his edge to halt his momentum and make a pad save back to the blocker side. Again, he quickly recovers and drops into a block to make yet another save. As I mentioned in the traits, Markstrom's compete level has been taken to another level, and this sequence shows that as he makes three saves from the inner slot in succession on multiple broken plays. Here's our last line rush clip, and it is a highlight reel save by Markstrom. It is a 2-on-1 for the Sharks with Joel Kellman carrying the puck. Markstrom is just outside the top of his crease as he begins his retreat. Kellman does an excellent job of freezing Markstrom by having the puck in the shooting position before firing a pass to LeMank on the backside. Markstrom still demonstrates great head and eye habits as he leads with them. This allows him to recognize that he is behind the play. Recognizing that he is in this situation, he makes a desperation push and two pad stack as LeBanc catches and releases and shoots high glove. Markstrom throws his pad and glove up towards the puck and makes just a ridiculous save. As many of my students know, I'm not a proponent of two pad stacks or these Ferris wheel type saves, but in desperation, anything goes to make the save. And one thing I do want to point out is even in this situation of desperation, Markstrom's head and eyes are still on the puck, which allowed him the best opportunity to make a save, even from an awkward position. There's no wonder this save was posted all over top 10 lists this season. Now we're going to move to in-zone plays with a focus on above-the-line situations. First, we're going to introduce some of the traits we will look at in Markstrom's game. Markstrom's first above-the-line trait is his hockey IQ. He frequently displays high hockey IQ and spatial awareness through the use of shoulder checks in nearly all these clips. He also uses verbal and nonverbal cues to communicate with his teammates. One clip in particular demonstrates these communication traits, and I want you to pay attention. Markstrom's second trait is his edges and compete. On the inevitable rebound situations in above-the-line situations, it is really fun to watch how well Markstrom gets to his edges in battle for rebound chances. Similar to line rush plays, we can learn a lot by how active and competitive Markstrom is in his efforts to find the puck and get his body behind it. Markstrom's third positive trait is his tracking habits. He has the ability to track and find lanes through traffic and is just absolutely uncanny. It is very rare to see him just drop and block on pucks, which you often see with big-frame goalies. Be sure to pay attention to how well he is able to find these lanes and utilize his great tracking habits. Markstrom's last trait is both a positive and a negative, which is his balance. In general, Markstrom does a good job keeping his torso upright, but on a few plays, be sure to note how his upper body swings, which causes him to get a bit out of control, and how this could potentially hurt us if we were to play these situations similarly. Our first clip starts with a scrum in the corner. As the play moves to the hash marks, I love how Markstrom rotates in front of his post to get square to a potential dead angle shot. The puck moves to the point and Markstrom gets to his spot early and is set for the shot. The D holds and the two players in front end up bumping into Markstrom, but he quickly readjusts and then makes an excellent blocker save and steers the puck out of play. Great job staying focused on the task at hand and not getting thrown off by the traffic in front. This play starts off the rush with a quick shot by Kajula looking for a rebound to the far pad. Markstrom steers it and quickly recovers to the far post. Notice Markstrom's great use of the shoulder check because there is no immediate shot threat. The puck is moved to the slot and Markstrom beats it on his feet, and the puck is dropped to another Blackhawks attacker. The player makes a great pass to the open man on the faceoff dot. Markstrom slides on a perfect path to his post, but note, he's a little off balance, and if the shot were taken against the grain, it would have been really difficult for him to recover or maybe even make the first save. But it's a great read and save sequence as he's able to contain the rebound and hold for a whistle. This play demonstrates great hockey IQ and communication skills on a broken play by Markstrom. It starts with a pass to the weak side D. I like how he utilizes a quick relaxed stance to find a path to the puck and recognizes the shot threat and settles into his ready position. The Canucks forward blocks the shot and it pops up straight into the air. Markstrom utilizes his great visual attachment skills and watches how he points out with his glove to signify to his players where the puck is. It's safe to assume he's yelling something like, up, up, or something along those lines. The puck lands in the slot and the Kings player swats at it towards the net, and Markstrom makes a solid save on a dangerous chance. This is a great display of communication, which helps his D and himself identify where the puck is off a funny ricochet off the shin pad. Communication with our players is crucial to help not only your teammates, but also yourself understand where the puck is and where the opposition is located on the ice. This situation shows Markstrom's excellent edge work. It starts with Kajula taking a shot off a skate to the corner. Notice Markstrom's quick shoulder check where he identifies a passing threat off the weak side. Kajula then forces a turnover and the Hawks player makes a quick pass to Kubalik, who was that initial attacker to the far post. Markstrom feels the presence of Kubalik close to him and slides in anticipation of a quick one-timer. Because his head and eyes lead his body, he notices Kubalik is trying to bring the puck back against the grain. Look how quickly he gets to his glove side edge to stop his momentum and makes an outstanding save. As we get into higher levels, this ability to change direction on a dime is crucial, and one that takes a lot of repetition and practice. Great sequence by Markstrom. This is a really fun sequence on a Blackhawks power play. Patrick Kane breaks into the zone with speed and kicks it to the outside. Again, notice how Markstrom is pointing to his teammate to watch for Kane in the high slot, and he's very likely communicating verbally as well. The pass is made to Kane and he takes a quick shot high blocker. Markstrom decides to hold his post and try to track from a stationary position. This is one of the rare situations where Markstrom drops his chin and fails to track the puck. The shot hits the bar and drops directly in front. Notice Markstrom doesn't admit defeat, assuming that Kane's shot went in, nor does he panic and worry that or get himself in a scramble. He quickly finds the puck and stays compact to make the second save. The puck then squirts out and is passed up top. He recovers to his feet, ready for the next attack in his relaxed stance. The pass is made to Kubalik on the flank, and Markstrom beats it on his feet with a powerful T-push. The shot is taken high blocker, and notice Markstrom's excellent posture as he is able to shrug his shoulder up and the puck goes out of play. Again, notice how he snaps his head around to find the puck and initiate his recovery even after making the save. Excellent poise and hockey sense on this crazy sequence of events. Here's a goal against clip against the Sharks. There are a lot of positives in this clip that I think show that goals happen even when we have good habits, and we want to emphasize process over results to become a consistent rock in the net. The puck is moved to Hurdle on the half wall, and I like how Markstrom adjusts to the inside shoulder of the screen to find the puck. The pass is made to the weak side defenseman heading towards the net. Markstrom beats the pass on his feet and leans to find the puck across the screen. He projects where it'll end up and makes a good save to his glove side. He's in a good position to recover as you can see his head and eyes have stayed on the puck as he readies himself to power slide on the rebound. The shot is released high glove and the only two adjustments that he could possibly make to change the outcome are change his path to the post, he pushes a bit flat instead of towards diagonally to the post, and his glove position. Notice how his fingers drop into a blocking butterfly. The shot flies past his ear resulting in a goal. Again, even on this goal against clip, there's a lot of good that could be taken from this scenario. His pre-shot movement was excellent, and projecting through traffic was also great, as was the explosive push on the rebound. But at the highest level, details matter, and two very minor mistakes result in the red light going on. This play starts with a pass to the weak side D at the blue line at the tail end of a power play. Markstrom is in his relaxed stance, broadening his field of sight. As Keith winds up, he readies himself and quickly adjusts to center. The puck is saved, and the rebound pops out to Kirby Dach on the weak side. He pulls the puck to his forehand, and Markstrom power slides. Then Dach makes a slick move to pull it to his backhand. As you can see, Markstrom loses his balance, but does a great job just finding a way to make a save with his backside leg. He holds onto the rebound and gets a whistle. This clip shows that Markstrom would have made his life easier by maintaining his balance on the rebound. But sometimes we do make errors, and we have to find a way to make a save at all costs. It doesn't always have to be pretty on these scramble situations, as long as we keep the puck out. The clip starts with the Hurricanes attacker swinging up high before heading downhill towards the net. As you can see, there's at least 4 to 5 bodies directly in Markstrom's lane. And he does a good job utilizing his relaxed stance to combat this. The Hurricanes player does a good job keeping the puck in a shooting position, and Markstrom gets into his reactive stance. The pass is made to Hamilton, who sneaks off to the weak side. Markstrom is a little late reacting through traffic and realizes that he must slide to get to the puck. He takes a perfect path towards his post, and Hamilton shoots back against the grain. Watch Markstrom's head and eyes. They are right on the puck as he tracks it into his glove. This is a great save, but again, be cognizant of falling on our butt. If he doesn't catch his puck cleanly, he's not in an optimal position to get to a rebound. This is our last above-the-line clip, and it's an outstanding display of edgework, athleticism, and compete. It is at the end of a 4-on-4 situation, and Jankowski attacks the two Canucks defenders head-on. He slips past 1D, and the other defenseman comes across for help. Markstrom is ready for the release as Jankowski cuts back again, is in a prime scoring position. Markstrom drops in his butterfly, anticipating a shot, and Jankowski makes a great pass to Goodrow on the back door. Most goalies would be down and out and watch Goodrow just tap the puck into the open net, but Markstrom loads up on his glove side leg, rotates to push, and extend to make the save. What an excellent save, and highlights some of Markstrom's best qualities in these above-the-line situations. Now we're going to shift our focus to low plays and look at the traits we will be highlighting for Markstrom in these situations. Our first trait is efficiency and control. Markstrom does a great job utilizing his frame in these low play situations. He remains calm and in control on scrambles and does a great job building his coverage from the ground up. Markstrom's next trait is his post-integration. He's RVH only on these types of plays, but you can tell how much work he has put in to master this position. He's almost always well connected to his post with his key points of contact maintained. Markstrom's third trait is his active stick. Because he's well connected and well positioned, he's able to deter pass outs, and there's a couple clips where he blocks these pass outs because of good positioning and hockey sense. His stick is almost always in the passing lane. A potential flaw in his low play positions is being an RVH early. I find Markstrom ends up defaulting into this position on any type of play below the goal line, and he can get away with it because of his size and athletic ability, but I would caution when watching these clips and think critically to determine whether you can be successful in this position. First clip will highlight Markstrom's integration skills and use of stick to buy himself time. It starts with Adam Fox getting the puck down low below the goal line. Markstrom is down in RVH, and you can see he is a good seal and elects to be skate to post with a great stick in the passing lane. Markstrom's stick negates the passing option in front to the Rangers attacker. Fox does make a great pass to the second wave attacker at the top of the circle. Markstrom holds his post, trusting his ability to track from a stationary position. He finds a sight line to see the puck and finds it going to his blocker side. He bumps off his post and makes an excellent blocker save and recovers immediately. Great reactionary save, and I liked his active stick, which forced Fox to hit the trailer versus the net front player. This is a shorthanded attack by the Rangers, with Zibanejad gaining possession behind the net. As you can see, Markstrom is down early in RVH, which I don't necessarily recommend, but his decision-making from here is excellent. He takes a scan to identify passing threats as Zibanejad attacks towards the net, and Markstrom goes for the old-school stick extension to block the pass. This buys him time to quickly recover and get his frame behind the shot by Fast. Unfortunately, the ref blows the whistle, but I love he was trying to keep the puck moving on the Canucks power play. Great active stick, and I love how he pulls the stick back quickly and gets himself into position after this block pass. Great read and scenario. Here's a goal against clip where Markstrom gets a bit too over-aggressive with his stick and feel he drops an RVH a bit early. The play starts behind the goal line and Kreider wins a race to the puck in the corner. I feel like it's unnecessary to be down an RVH with there being no immediate shot threat. The puck gets back into Kreider's hands after a quick battle, and Markstrom reaches to stick jab, but Kreider's a little far from the net and gets around it and makes a nice pass backdoor to Buchnevich. Because his weight gets outside the post with the stick jab, it slows down his ability to push and use the post as leverage, and Buchnevich finds the open net. While I do like Markstrom's active stick in most situations, we have to be careful of its limits and understand what happens when we overreach when there are passing options. A good teaching lesson for all our viewers. Here's another active stick clip and shows a good understanding of when to be aggressive with our stick blade. The puck starts at the goal line and you can see Markstrom is in the middle of a shoulder check. Markstrom gets his eyes back on Taves, and as he moves towards the net, Markstrom drops into RVH with a clean seal. Notice the heel of his stick blade is on the toe of his skate, so that's just a great position. Markstrom leads with his stick towards the puck, which allows him to keep the puck behind the net. The play moves behind the net and Canucks get possession. This is a really simple clip, but Markstrom's excellent details and post positioning make his life easy. Now we're going to look at a couple dead angle situations. The first starts with Meyer of the Sharks attacking wide outside the faceoff dot. Meyer is on his backhand and Markstrom drops into RVH. Markstrom does a good job getting his points of contact and the backhand is taken. Markstrom seals the post to make the save and keeps the puck in front of his body when he covers it. Markstrom likes using RVH in all dead angle situations, and I definitely agree with his decision here with Evander Kane on the back door. Had he gone into overlap a pass was made, it would have been very difficult to get across. On this dead angle situation, I want you to pay attention to Markstrom's seal. Panarin gets to the puck, and once he reaches the bottom of the circle, Markstrom drops into RVH. Panarin tries to squeeze the puck between his ear and the post and almost hits a spot. Watch Markstrom's head and eyes. He leans forward and down, which exposes a little bit of space over his shoulder. highly skilled players like Panarin can hit these tight spots. So we have to be sure to lean in. When we lean into our post, there is no gaps in our coverage. So sometimes we're even going to have to lean with our head towards the post. Markstrom is fortunate this dead angle shot doesn't end up in the net. This is a good teaching moment for us, and especially with a 6'6 goalie, we can notice there can be gaps in our coverage. So the majority of the goalies watching this have to be very careful using this tool on dead angle situations. Here's our last dead angle clip, and it shows a great seal and read by Markstrom. A funny bounce ends up on the Hurricane stick blade, who makes a pass over to Ryan Dzingel. Markstrom flows back into his post with Dzingel in a shooting position. Dzingel looks to shoot short side, and Markstrom has a great seal and posture, with his shoulders sitting nice and tall. As the puck is released, Markstrom recognizes the shot flight and takes a secondary lean to get in his shoulder tight to the post. He fights it off and maintains visual attachment and follows the play off his body. Great read and sequence to recognize Dzingel trying to beat him high short side and taking that secondary lean to make sure there's no space between him and the post. Now we're going to finish with a few scramble scenarios. Through all three of these, watch how calm and efficient Markstrom is. There is no panic or holes in his coverage. The first starts with the Flames attacker moving towards the net below the goal line. Markstrom is in RVH, and I like his active stick to get a piece of the pass out. The puck pops up in the air out into the slot, and watch Markstrom's head and eyes and his shoulders as he maintains visual attachment and his upper body is on top of the puck. He stays compact as the puck is swatted towards the net. He realizes he doesn't have it and quickly pushes to his post and to recover and takes a quick shoulder check before recovering to his feet. Great sequence and just excellent job maintaining his composure in a pretty difficult situation. The play starts in the corner with Markstrom and RVH. As the play or puck is cycled, Markstrom recovers to his feet. The Sharks player makes a nice indirect pass off the wall. Markstrom makes a great read to slide as he sinks to his post and gets his head and eyes on top of the puck as the attacker gets just above the goal line. Markstrom rotates to get his shoulders on top of the puck and fights off the first shot. From there, mayhem ensues. Even with all the bodies in front, watch how Markstrom battles for a potential rebound while staying calm and sealing the bottom portion of the ice with his paddle. The puck is retrieved by the Canucks and carried out of the zone. Here's our last clip for Jacob Markstrom. Backlund has the puck behind the net, and Markstrom is stretched post to post with his skates, looking over his glove side shoulder. Again, because he is 6'6", it allows him to be in this position with relative ease, but it's not always recommended for the average goalie. Backlund makes a great pass to the opposite side to Tkachuk. Markstrom does a great job of turning his head and getting his upper body leaned into the post as the shot is taken. The rebound then pops loose, and Markstrom makes a couple saves and does a pretty good job repositioning himself and battling to get his head and eyes on top of the puck. I like how that he is in control throughout this scramble situation, and he avoids any desperation type saves and keeps his upper body upright.